Hi, welcome back. This is SL from Danalyser, and today we are going to work on a formula called format datetime. So we are going to convert a timestamp from this format to another format. If you have watched my previous video on datetime related formulas, you have probably came across this function. But in today's video, we are going to cover in more detail how you can use it to format your date into multiple formats. Here, I've included two examples for the dates. And towards the end of the video, I will also include a bonus tip on how you can format this timestamp into a 24-hour time format. So without further ado, let's get started. So first of all, I have already have my data set here imported. So I'm going to use this order paid field as my example today. And now I will start with the first example, which is to convert this timestamp into this number format that we would usually see in our reports. So first of all, I would want to tell you that in order to format the date, you will need to refer to this formula syntax. So first of all, this syntax contains a format string and followed by the date time expression. So this is actually your date field. For the format string, it's actually the format that you want the result to be. So for example, if you want to convert the default format of the date time or the date from one to another, so if let's say this is the result that you want, you will need to use this specific format string to to tell Data Studio that you need this specific format. Data Studio has a specific elements that will allow you to define the format. And here, this is the table that contains all the formats that supported in Data Studio. So for example, you will see this element, and it's representing the full weekday name. And we also have the short one, which is the abbreviated version, represented by smaller a. And we also have the same thing for the month, and we also have other format that you would probably need. So in today's one, I will focus on three format, which is the one that I've noted here for your reference. So first of all, I'm going to create a new field over here. Let me just move me over here. So first of all, I'm going to add the field here. So just click add the field, and here let's give it a new name and call it as date format one. And in this date formula, I'm going to use the same formula that I told you, which is format date time. And as I mentioned, the first formula that I'm going to show you is this one. So we're going to convert into this formula. Hence, we'll be using the combination of these format elements. So I'm just going to follow exactly. I'm going to have the percent capital Y and percent small letter M and percent small letter D. So take note on the small letter and capital letter because it's case sensitive, as I showed you in the table just now. Small letter and capital letter represent different formats, so be careful on this. And we'll key in comma and follow by the date field. So just now I mentioned I want to use the order paid as our example. So here I'm just going to type in that. You can see there's one green tick over here. That means this formula syntax is correct and is safe to save. And you can click finish. So now I'm going to drag and drop this field into my dimension and see what formula I'm getting. Sorry, what format I'm getting. So you can see with this simple formula, we have converted the date time into a specific date formula that we want. This is in a numeric format. But one thing that you will need to notice is that now instead of date, dimension, data type, this formatted date is actually now a text. So this would cause some error when you are trying to insert a time series chart. So for example, let's try to do it. Let's say if I want to use this date format as the dimension, it won't show us anything because it's not a date and it's not supported in time series chart. So what you would do normally is to use a bar chart, and you can sort the date based on that. So that's how you do, and you can just sort the date in ascending. So it kind of, you know, follow like a time series chart, and you can change it to line chart if you want. Sorry, where's the line chart? Yeah, you can change it to line chart if you want. So that's how we do it. Next, I'm going to show you how you can convert your date or your timestamp into this formula right here. So same thing, we are going to add a new field. By the way, if you are comfortable with using formulas, you can just go ahead and test things out. So it helps you to remember the concept and the syntax easily if you do some hands-on. So now I'm going to just show you the example. If let's say you want your date in this format. So now I'm going to just save date format 2 and use the same formula again. Here just use percent C, and same thing, we're going to use the same date, which is order paid, and click save and finish. Now the new field, just add it in our table. Wait a minute, did I did something wrong? Oh, it's percent X, my bad. It's X. Okay, so now I'm just going to update this formula and click finish. And yes, so yep, we are getting the date format that we want, which is this one over here. So I noticed that I actually wanted this format with 4 digit of the year behind, but now I'm getting 2 digit, which I think again is my mistake. I'm so sorry for this, but it's a good chance for us to, you know, work together in this case. So it seems that I'm taking the wrong format, and this format is true that it's going to return us a 2-digit year. And as I scroll through, I actually don't see any format that would give me the format that I want. So now I'm going to reuse the previous format that I use and customize it to build the date format that I want. So now I want to start from day first. So So what I will do is I'll take this percent %d and put it in front. So it's kind of like we're rearranging the date parts. So now I'm moving the date to the front. And instead of hyphen, now I'm going to use slash. If you want it to be dot, you can just use dot. So now I'm going to just use slash. And for the month, I'm going to just follow it as it is. And for the year, I can also use back the same one. So what I need to do now is to go and create a third formula. And same thing, same formula, and I'm just pasting the format that I just built using the date element. And here I'm using back the same field, and I can click save and finish. Okay, now I'm just adding this into the table. Now you get to see that I have the date computed based on what I need. So now I have covered the custom format. This is not intended, but yeah, I guess we just have to go with it. Next, I will also teach you how you can add a day of week in front of your date format. So I think you can do this yourself using the table in here. So play around with it and see if you can convert the date here into this format. And now I will guide you on how to do the front part. So what I will do is to go to this table, sorry, this one, and look for week day. Weekday name. Okay, so if you see previous one, this is actually a full name. So I'm going to grab this percent %a, just copy that, and I would just add a new field. Let's call it date format 4. And format the time formula in here. Here, using this one, percent %a, key in the percent %a. In here, you can see that I added a comma, and then I will add a space because I want to have some space after we added the week of day, which is the week name. And we are going to follow by one of the date. Let's just use the second one because it's easy. So now you can see that we have computed almost the same formula here. Yep, and before we end this video, initially I thought of giving you 2 examples, but now we have given you 4 examples now. And the last one will be extracting the time from this timestamp. And I'm sure you already know how to do it, but since I promise you I'll show you how to do it, I'm going to just do it anyway. So just add a field, and this is time format 1. Here, just use the same thing, format the time. And use capital H, percent capital H, and then symbol, and followed by M, capital M. And then same thing, we're going to use back the same timestamp that we used in our previous example. Click save and finish. And we're going to see the last magic. So now you get the 24-hour time format in the last column. And the good thing that you put it in this table is that you can see the changes over time as we transform the data. So I hope this tutorial is useful for you in formatting your date, your timestamp, and your time data. If you find this tutorial useful, do give me a like and comment in the video below, and I'll appreciate that very much. Thank you, and I'll see you next time. Bye bye.